Hello, everybody. Can you see the creator here? Sorry, I got cut off before. But it turns out I only have like 4 minutes to make a video, so I might have to break this into like 4 parts. Anyway, where was I again? Oh, yeah. Nagisa is adorable. Pure, and I love how she loves the Danko family. Like, it is adorable, like, how she won't make an exact argument why the Danko family is cute. And I totally relate to her, because I will defend my favorite anime characters to the very end, as well as all you other otakus. So we all can relate to how she would defend it. There's Toma as a prankster, which I like, but sometimes can get annoying. He is also a kind-hearted person, and I like that. Plus, I like that he helps all his friends, like when he kept visiting Kotomi when she wouldn't leave her house because of something she remembered from her past. That whole arc of, like, when she remembered something from her past and, like, how traumatized she was, that really made me scared. I was like, Kotomi, are you okay, Kotomi? Oh my gosh. What is going on? And I was really, and like I said, I was really sad about Kotomi's past and the fact that she has lost her parents at such a young age. Like, any time in anime when they tell that story about losing their parents at a young age, a part of me dies inside. I'm like, you did not deserve that. And sometimes it'd be for the evil characters. I'm like, sure, you were evil, but nobody deserves to lose their parents at such a young age. And that scene when she got the teddy bear from her guardian, I was like, aww. That was adorable. I also like the flashback of how Kotomi and Tomio met. That was actually very cute too. But I hated that they kept playing it over and over again. Like we get it. You don't need to play it 1,000 times. I love Akio and Sane, Nagisa's parents. They are crazy, overdramatic, and hilarious. I love the running gag of, like, Sane, hey, we're away, running out of the bakery crying because nobody will eat her bread. And, like, Akio going after her saying, I like your bread. That thing is hilarious. Everything in this show is hilarious. Like, I cracked up so many times. And let me tell you, at first, I was a little critical about that whole, like, scene whenever in the opening they would show that dang robot. And, like, they would show that robot and talking about life. And I was like, what's up with this robot? What the heck is even going on? Like, what is this even about? Then later, I figured out it was part of the play. And I was like, oh. Okay, now I get it. You couldn't have been more vague. Like, I was so confused what the heck was happening. It was so vague. I was so confused. Fukio being an apparition. When we figured out that she was actually dead, like, her actual buddy is dead, I was like, what? What? She's dead? How the heck does that work? I was thinking the same way Tomia was thinking. Nah, she can't be a ghost. There's no way. And then he figures out that she really is a ghost. And like that scene where they had a little birthday party for her. That was really cute. I really loved that. I really adored that. This thing might unexpectedly turn off in a few minutes. So, I'm sorry in advance. Kyo. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. Kyo is way too honest, but I still like her prankster image. Like, I like that. And also, I forgot to say, when they were starting to forget about Fukio, I was crying desperately. Don't you dare care off. Don't you dare kill off my favorite character. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. But when I asked, don't you dare kill off my favorite character, I didn't mean just have them for. I didn't mean just have her keep randomly appeared out of nowhere just at the drop of a hat. That's not what I meant. Also, guys, Do y'all still like my headphones? They're really cute, aren't they? I like Kyo's sister. But there wasn't really much to her besides fortune telling. But besides that, it was actually pretty good. Or that could be the librarian I'm thinking of. But I'm pretty sure that was Kyo's sister who was doing fortune telling. Kotomi is a great person. I like that she is a genius character and she's a nice, quiet person. And like I said, her backstory, really deep. Hit me right here. I also like how Kyo is vaguely hinting to everybody she likes Tobia. Yeah, treats him coldly. And like how she actually was getting jealous that Tobia being with Tobia. Like, I actually like that scene. It was actually very cute and adorable. Sonohara's little sister, Mei, is adorable, cares about her brother, and is nice. Like, Mei showing up in the show is just great. And she is, and I think I might confirm that she is my favorite little sister character. Like, I really feel like I really like her. Kyo ended up brokenhearted after she read out who Tomiya likes. And when he finally confirmed that, I was like, yes! Finally! You finally asked her out! What took you so long? And like, how he blushed, how him and Nagisa blushed so hard when they tried to touch each other's hair, like when they tried to hold each other's hands, that was the most adorablest thing I ever seen. Like, that was adorable. I loved the picnic episode. And I love how, throughout the series, how much Nagisa has grown. She's not too much of a pushover. She's still kinda a bit, but she's not that much of a pushover. Sunny, and we also figure out a backstory about Sunny was a middle school teacher, and Akio was an actor. I didn't know that Akio was an actor. I didn't know that Sunny was a teacher, though. I did know about her being a teacher, but I didn't know that Akio was an actor. So that was actually news to me. And I gotta be honest, Akio being an actor makes sense. That guy is always so overdramatic, and like his wife does not help. Like, Sunny is just as dramatic as Akio. Like, they are both a dramatic duo, and that is why they are perfect for each other. And like, it makes sense about their backstory and why they gave up their careers, because they wanted to spend more time with Nagisa, and she was just getting sick too easily. Any parent would have done that. And I like the scene at the end where Akio said, "No, you are our dream. Every parent's dream is to see their child happy." So that was normal, and that was adorable. I love that scene so much. And let me tell you, that was the last episode was really weird. Like, they just randomly had it. I think it was supposed to be like an OVA, but they made it part of the series anyway, about Tomiya and Tomiyo becoming a couple. I'm like, what? Listen, I can imagine him ending up in a relief. I can imagine like an episode where he ended up with Kyo. That would have been funny. That would have been funny, because I just really want to imagine what their relationship would have been if Kyo and Tomiya had ever been in a relationship. But apparently the fans thought, no, Tomiya and Tomiya, that would be a cuter relationship. Why not just have him end up with Kotomi? Because in the OVA, because if this was supposed to be an OVA, him ended up with Kotomi, way better. Because Kotomi is almost like the closest near to like Nagisa's character. So I feel like him ending up with Kotomi would have been way better. But hey, I'm not the rat. I'm not the writer of the show, so what do I know? Anyway, it really was a really good anime, and I will watch Clannad After Storm. So yeah, that review will come out, but don't expect it to come out real soon, because the only reason why I rushed Clannad was because I just felt like if I didn't finish this now, I'd never finish it. So yeah. Anyway, that's my review. That's the rest of my review of Clannad. I give this a 10 out of 10. Definitely will recommend. I love it. And anybody who's unsure about watching it, y'all should watch it. And by the way, if y'all wondering, I did not watch the English version. I watched the full Japanese version. So that's my, like I said, 10 out of 10. Definitely recommend. For anybody who has a... Watch Clannad. It's funny. It's cute. It's everything you need. So enjoy. Bye. Like and comment and subscribe.